Self-ionization of water. This is an interesting equation, water plus water. But if we envision one of these water molecules as a Lewis acid and it's donating a proton, then what we can get is H3O plus plus OH minus. And admittedly, the position of equilibrium lies far to the left. We don't get very much H3O plus and OH minus, but what we do get is significant. H3O plus is called a hydronium ion, OH minus the hydroxide ion. And as I mentioned, the concentration is pretty low of these species on the right-hand side. If it's pure water, 10 to the minus 7th molar and 10 to the minus 7th molar. And when we have a condition, as I've just outlined, when H3O plus concentration is equal to OH minus concentration, it's said to be a neutral condition. If H3O plus, you recognize this as the acidic or the acid component, is greater than a basic component, then the solution is said to be acidic. If the opposite case holds, if OH minus concentration is greater, then we say it's a basic solution. Brackets indicate concentration, and we know that the concentration of H3O plus times the concentration of OH minus is equal to a constant. It's called the ion product of water, and we can evaluate that constant because we know at neutrality the concentration of each of these is 10 to the minus 7th molar. So it must be true that the ion product of water is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14th molar. Given an equation like this, it leads us to a skill that we'd like you to have. Given the H3O plus concentration or OH minus, we'd like you to be able to solve for the other and to tell whether the solution is acidic, basic, or neutral. For example, if we have an H3O plus concentration of 1 times 10 to the minus 5, what's the OH minus concentration? If I encountered this question on a quiz or an exam, I'd say, hey, I see numbers. This is a math skill we're looking at, and we have a formula for it. So the very first thing I do is write down the formula because that's our roadmap, and then substitute into the formula. For the H3O plus, we'd have 1 times 10 to the minus 5. And now our objective is to get the unknown on one side of the equation and all the numbers on the other side. So we divide each side by 1 times 10 to the minus 5th. And that gives us what we've got up here. OH minus concentration is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14 over 1 times 10 to the minus 5. You know the rules for dividing exponential numbers. It's the exponent of the numerator minus that of the denominator. So a minus 5 would be a plus 5. A plus 5 and a minus 14 would be a minus 9. Or another way of doing that is to simply take the denominator up and put it into the numerator. Whenever you cross that line, the exponent changes sign, and you'd simply add. So a minus 5 as it goes up becomes a plus 5, plus 5, and a minus 14 is a minus 9. And the H3O plus concentration that we started with was 1 times 10 to the minus 5. So we've solved for both of these, and now the final question, is it an acidic, basic, or neutral solution? We'd ask ourselves, which of these two terms is the greater? And because it's a negative exponent, it's actually the smaller number, the 5, that represents the greater component. So the acidic component wins out, the solution is acidic. Let's look at a little bit harder problem. In this case, we've got a number that isn't 1. We've got 2.6 times 10 to the minus 11th. And the question is, what's the H3O plus concentration if that is the OH negative concentration? Here's our ion product of water. We'd substitute in for the OH. The objective again, get all the numbers on the right-hand side. the unknown on the left-hand side. Here's the expression, 1 times 10 to the minus 14 divided by 2.6 times 10 to the minus 11. Some of you have calculators that easily handle these exponents. I'm a little bit old-fashioned. I'm going to rearrange this into 1 over 2.6 and then solve for this exponent. 10 to the minus 14 over 10 to the minus 11 is 10 to the minus 3. Or if I take that 11 up, it changes sign. A plus 11 and a minus 14 would be a minus 3. So we're halfway there. 1 over 2.6, then I divide on my calculator, comes out to 0.38 to two significant figures, times 10 to the minus 3. Then we'd want to place that in standard scientific notation with the decimal after the first digit. It becomes 3.8. And if I move the decimal one place to the right, I'd balance that by indicating one more place to the left. So it becomes 10 to the minus 4. Here was our given OH minus concentration. Comparing that to the H3O plus, again, because these are negative exponents, we'd look for the smaller number. That's the greater concentration. And again, the solution is acidic.